We are in G2S, Great Works to Southam, south section. And here is the work location for Edgcote Viaduct, where we're building 515 meters viaduct for HS2. Viaduct itself, it's 515 meters viaduct. We have 20 piers and 2 abutments. The width of the viaduct itself is around 14 meters, and the height of it, it can vary between 5.5 to 6.5 meters. And as you can see, 2 piers, we have done the lifting today, and they are like 5 to 6 meters high. For installing piers, we're using 2 cranes simultaneously. It's a tendon lift, and as soon as we finish the piers and we get moving forward for the installation of the beams, we using super lift with just 1 crane to install 25 meters precast beams for the viaduct. We using around 60% of viaduct as a precast manufacturer. Our precast facility located in Kent, Pocodar factory, and they are delivering to us precast piers, precast beams, precast plunks, and parapets. In terms of how we actually building the viaduct, it's a start from piling process. So we have 35 meters long pile underneath the ground, and we have pile cap above the piles, and we have precast piers above the pile cap. And after that, we're lifting precast beams over the piers, and then job will progress with putting plunks and building the deck. The reason we're building the viaduct is like five to six meters high is because of the floodplain, and no matter what weather condition we're facing in future, HS2 train can continue to run on this viaduct. It's a very similar design to Thames Valley Viaduct, which is in other section of EKFB. And we implemented a lot of lessons learned from Thames Valley Viaduct to increase the efficiency and do the job in a better way. It's really great to see what we can accomplish when we are all pulled together. I've been involved in this project from very beginning, and it's just amazing to see the result of our works.